Good afternoon and welcome to the first edition of Off the Cuff of 2019. I hope everybody had a great holiday season and a happy new year. I'd like to cover some of the events that took place over the month of December. It was a busy month as usual, and really we kicked off the month of December starting with a very important and meaningful announcement at the Oswego YMCA. And at the Oswego YMCA, I announced $75,000 in funding to the YMCA, split in two separate groups. The first group of funding was $50,000 to the YMCA to help with the pool connector project. That's a project that will connect the YMCA to where the pool used to be in the old YMCA, so that members can use the pool, and the YMCA can offer swimming classes and lessons once again. That's an important project. First of all, it's very important that we recognize how positive it is to have a YMCA in our downtown and in our community to begin with. I travel throughout upstate New York all summer long with my family business, and not every community can say that they have a YMCA in their immediate community, and they don't always have access to all the services and opportunities that a YMCA has. So that's very important. The fact that it's in our downtown makes it even more important and beneficial. What we've identified is that the membership numbers would increase for the YMCA if they have access to a pool, which obviously they do not have now. And that's what makes that project so very important. So I think the $50,000 to help expedite, move that project along, make sure it comes to fruition, was a worthwhile investment. The money that we use to do this, to offer this grant, is from the Economic Development Office. It's from New York State. It's pretty much money that we've had left over through several grants. We've done a nice job remaining in compliance with administering grants, so we have this money available to kind of dish out, if you will, as long as it's tied to job creation. And the pool connector project will create 6 jobs, so that's another reason why we thought it was a worthwhile investment. The remaining money of the $75,000 is $25,000, and that's going to the Oswego Boxing Club at the YMCA, which is housed in the basement of the YMCA. The boxing club is run by two local Oswego residents who really started from scratch and built that club up from literally nothing, and it's really a remarkable story to see how much the boxing club has grown and to see the outreach and the impact it has on our youth. So it's just another service, it's another opportunity that the youth in Oswego has that not every community has, is access to a boxing club. It's very important, and it keeps our youth off the streets and out of trouble. And it just gives them another option to do so. This boxing club has really come a long way, and their partnership with the YMCA has helped really compound the gains they've made. The $25,000 will be used for improvements to the boxing ring, some improvements to the lighting in the facility, and also help with the program administrator, who will go out and expand the outreach and allow more class time for kids who participate in the boxing club. Right now it's run on 100% volunteers, so this paid staff will help elevate the program and reach more kids. Another grant that we dished out in December was a $130,000 grant to LeRoi Incorporated. LeRoi Incorporated is a business right now that is in Fulton, New York. And I took a tour of their facility, began talking to the owner, Terry LeRoi, who was interested in doing an expansion project. And I tried to get them to move to Oswego, and we used this $130,000 grant to help them move to Oswego. The money was applied towards the purchase of the building on 2nd and Utica Street in Oswego. So they're moving in that location in April. And the big part of this announcement and that investment is he's moving his existing 40 jobs from Fulton to Oswego, and also the money he has to create 10 jobs to help fulfill the expansion and the grant funding in the immediate future, and possibly another 10 jobs, so it could be a total of 60 jobs in the next year or so. So those 50 jobs are promised and guaranteed by the end of 2019. So the location of the building is near downtown Oswego, so it's a great boost for job creation in the city. 50 new jobs in the city, 40 existing being relocated, 10 new ones immediately, and then possibly another 10 in the next year or so. And it's right near downtown, so that'll certainly help. Those folks will hopefully consider moving to Oswego if they don't live here already, but certainly under lunch break, after hours, will be more apt to come downtown and perhaps spend some money. So it's a good economic development announcement, and it's of course awesome to welcome another business. And this LeRoi jewelry company is they sell jewelry worldwide. It's a higher end jewelry company. So it's pretty impressive and important to have a company like that be able to call Oswego home, and we're ecstatic to have them here. Some more big news is we won a $934,000 grant to help revitalize and revive our Wrights Landing Marina, which is city owned and operated. That grant will help pay for a total project, which is $1.2 million, for upgrades to the pavilion and the implementation of more amenities like grills, patios, seating, and so forth down at the marina. We'll also install 4 fire pits for boaters and Oswego residents to go down and have a place to hang out with a fire by the lake. I think on the summer and during the summer months, that'll be a great new attraction. We're also renovating both bathroom buildings. When we did our waterfront feasibility study, one thing that recreational boaters cited as being important was the quality and availability of restrooms in a marina. So we want to really enhance and improve our restrooms so that we can do a better job attracting and retaining the boaters that we do have in our marina. So I look forward to that project getting off the ground. And then the last announcement from December that I think is important to mention is the implementation of body-worn cameras throughout the Oswego Police Department that received a lot of attention throughout Central New York. This is really an initiative that we started talking about back in 2016, but we only wanted to do it if we did it right and if the police officers bought into it and supported it. And a couple of years later, we think we found the right brand of camera, the right type of camera, and we have the support from the officers to implement these cameras. And quite frankly, I think it's the right thing to do because you hear the narrative and you hear these situations of police brutality and aggression, so on and so forth. And I think it's just another piece of evidence that can be offered when this narrative keeps reoccurring. So it provides safety to the officers. It, of course, provides safety to Oswego residents if they encounter, if they have a police encounter. And it just helps put some context into these situations. So I stand behind the Oswego Police Department. In my time as mayor, I'm not sure if we've ever had an instance, at least brought to my desk, of any sort of police brutality or aggression. They do a great job and are very professional, no matter who they're dealing with out in the public. And I think these cameras will just ensure that the evidence is presented clearly, the context around any situation is accurate, and will help support the Oswego Police Department as they do the job, the great job that they do each and every day. So as you can tell, it was quite a busy month. There were some other smaller announcements mixed in throughout the month as we were tying up the year. And the goal is to just maintain the momentum and build off of the progress that we've made all year as we head into 2019. I'll be delivering my State of the City address in the middle of January. And I look forward to following up with you after we deliver that address with what's coming up in 2019. Thank you.